Thank you very much, Nancy. So up next, we've got Justin Kelly, who is a master's student at the University of Melbourne, recognising the broader importance of science in the community and in conservation, and he joined Wilderness of the...
Wildlife of the Central Highlands.
Wildlife of the Central Highlands, Watch, as a committee member in 2017. Thanks, Justin.
So today I'll be representing Wildlife of the Central Highlands, or Watch, and I'll be talking about the work we've done on the ground in protecting the Leadbeater's possum, which is a critically endangered species in the Central Highlands of Victoria. So what can I say about the Central Highlands? Well, they're incredibly carbon-dense forests that are very complex. They provide over 80% of Melbourne's water in their water catchments. And they're beautiful places that have incredible tourism opportunity and spiritual nourishment. But for the purposes of today, and what I'll be talking to most is that they're incredibly biodiverse, and there's four threatened, or in the case of Leadbeater's possum, critically endangered species that you have. So Leadbeater's possum, yellow-bellied glider, greater glider and sooty owl are some of these four keystone species that you see mentioned a lot. So the ecosystem itself is an IUCN red-listed ecosystem, which means it's critically endangered, and studies have shown that it's at a 92% chance of collapse by the 2067, and if we compare it to previous old growth before colonialism, it's only got 1.16% old growth remaining. So it's in pretty dire straits. And why is this? Well, two major factors. The first is industrial scale logging that's been going on for decades. Has completely obliterated and fragmented the landscape. As you can see by this photo, it doesn't really leave much in between. The second is fire, which of course in 2009 we had the Black Saturday bushfires, which wiped out 45% of Leadbeater's possum habitat. As you again can see by this photo, it's very destructive on a large scale. So you add these two together, and you can see in the background photo that you've got the mix there of fire in the background, and just patches of logging in the foreground. So together you get the loss of hollow-bearing trees, those really old mountain ash trees that need 120 years to develop before they have hollows in them that support the wildlife we're looking for. So as we know by this cute little Leadbeater's possum, hollows are homes, and so recognising that in 2014 a government led advisory group called the Leadbeater Possum Advisory Group came up with a recommendation, or more correctly, a compromise, where they had a 200 metre protection buffers for every Leadbeater Possum site. Now, the ANU recommendation coming out of the Fenner School, David Lindemeyer's team at the Fenner School, at ANU, was that it should really be 1 kilometre based on actual science and the behaviour of the possum. But really it was a compromise to appease logging industry. And of course there's no such protection for gliders, for other gliders or other species like that. So really we're not really dealing with much, but you know, if you give the community that incentive, hopefully we can come up with some good protection. So that's what I'll talk about today and the work we do on the ground. So the first thing we want to do over at Watch is that we want to identify the high priority areas. We know the forests well, and we can say, hey, that's a good area of forest, why are they logging that? Hey, that's got some really awesome stags on it, or hollow-bearing trees, they shouldn't be logging that. Secondly, we go and utilise thermal imaging cameras that are on loan from the department to survey for the Leadbeater's possum, and as you can see there, they're not necessarily easy to get. They're short little red dots that hop around, and we need to record them and submit those recordings with GPS coordinates to the department so it can get protected. And so that's in an effort to make the government and Vic Forest accountable for what they do. And then, of course, the last thing we want is to protect that small little patch of forest for now, because that's all we currently can do. So I think the best way to look at this is look at it on a spatial scale. So obviously we have the Central Highlands just 60 to 90 minutes out from Melbourne. As you can see, there's some in National Park, which is mainly the Yarra Ranges National Park in Baw-Baw, but it's predominantly state forest able to be logged. So here are just Watch's Leadbeater's possum sighting. Of course, there's others that other scientists and Department of Environment have done, but those are ours there. So if we look at what that means in terms of that 200 metre exclusion buffer against logging, we see for one small citizen science organisation, hey, that's pretty good. We've protected over 1,500 hectares of forest. Now, of course, that should be a bit greater for you to really take into consideration that recommended 1 kilometre buffer. But then we think about, well, what are the threats? Fire, so the 2009 Black Saturday bushfire just destroyed huge amounts of forest and really has a lasting impact. And then what's probably most shocking is previous decades of logging. So, of course, big hollow-bearing trees need 120 years to really develop. So if you have logging in the past 50, 60 years, you're not really getting that complex vegetation you need. And then on top of that, you add in what is set to be logged in the coming year. This was the 2017 Timber Release Plan. And you ask yourself, well, what's really left outside some of those water catchments and national parks? And the answer is not much. So that's essentially the situation we're in, and that's why I think our work is so important. And of course, we're not just looking for leadbeater's possums. We're also looking for yellow-bellied gliders, although they don't get that buffer, greater gliders, and even tree G-bum species, which is a threatened tree species. So on a closer scale here, you can see three leadbeater possum sightings we had adjacent to a timber plantation. You can also see the historic logging that's occurred there, and it's discoloured in the satellite photo, so you can see it. And then you can see the new logging coop. So again, it's surprising, it's like there's not much habitat there, and they're hitting what little habitat there is there. Add to the fact that there's 7 greater gliders in that logging coop, and a couple of tree G-bum species. We not just have to report these sightings, but we really had to get the Environment Minister on board and protect this area of Hermitage Creek, which we eventually did. And of course, this is sort of what happens if we fail or if we can't really stop logging in a particular coop, is that wildlife unfortunately dies. So probably some of you are asking, well, how much is this citizen science? How much of it is activism? Or is it a bit of both? And the true answer is, like, as an organisation, we'd love to be doing maybe a lot more exploratory stuff. We'd like to be maybe partnering with more research institutions and doing maybe large-scale, long-term monitoring type stuff. Unfortunately, as long as habitat is being destroyed, we're going to do all we can to sort of block that path to extinction, or at least do what we can to protect some small parts of habitat. So that's it. Come visit me at the poster session. I've got a poster, and please ask any questions you have. I'm happy to talk and share some more.